And after the break, rocket scientist and author Olympia LePoint joins us live. We're going to hear her inspiring story and talk about today's spacewalk.
An exciting morning for Hawthorne-based SpaceX and NASA. Members of SpaceX Crew Dragon are on a spacewalk, which maybe we can show that spacewalk as it's happening. It started about an hour and a half ago, and this is the body cam from one of the astronauts who's up on the International Space Station right now. The Crew Dragon is performing a historic mission, but also something that they've never done before. In a few minutes, we're going to talk to rocket scientist and author Olympia LePoint, who's going to join us live. She's also going to talk about how NASA just renamed their headquarters after Mary Jackson. She was featured in Hidden Figures. Janelle Monáe played her, and she was an incredible engineer for NASA back in the day. We're going to go over to weather with Danielle for now. It is an exciting morning for Hawthorne-based SpaceX and NASA, too. Members of the SpaceX Crew Dragon are on a spacewalk, and rocket scientist and author Olympia LePoint is joining us live. We are so honored. Thank you for joining us, Olympia. Good morning.
Good morning.
So can you tell us why this mission is being called historic?
Oh, this historic mission is monumental. A SpaceX, NASA, Crew Dragon 2 was a flight that took humans into space. The last time we went into space was 2011. And so there's a couple of legs of the mission. The first leg is the successful launch. The second leg is actually doing the space walk with the exchanging of the energy cells of the International Space Station. Right now, there's nickel hydrogen batteries that need to be replaced. And right now, Cassidy, two astronauts, Cassidy and Bob Behnken, are out doing a spacewalk. And this spacewalk is monumental because they are verifying that the space station can continue to work, can continue to thrive, and we're verifying that spacewalk is possible with this new SpaceX Dragon vehicle mapped to the International Space Station.
Oh, so the first time happening. This is incredible. Thank you for enlightening us. I love hearing from a rocket scientist. So, Olympia, NASA just renamed its headquarters after the late African-American NASA engineer Mary Jackson. The movie Hidden Figures also brought her story to the big screen. Janelle Monáe played her. Can you tell us about her incredible legacy?
Yes. Now, we have many people across the United States have seen the movie Hidden Figures. It was about three real-life mathematicians just like myself who helped win the space race in 1969 when the American public landed the first man on the moon. And NASA headquarters in D.C. was renamed after Mary Jackson. Now, Mary Jackson was a significant hidden figure, if you will. She was the first African-American woman to be in NASA and to help with the calculations to help us win the space race. And NASA is honored to now commemorate and to honor a building after the legacy of Mary Jackson. And I am honored to follow in her legacy.
Oh, congratulations. It's just incredible. And you yourself, you've written several books, you've lectured at our local universities and have given numerous inspiring talks about the struggles you personally have overcome from poverty and gang violence. What is the formula for your success?
For me, the success that came was when I had education and when I had mentors. I am a proponent and I am a person who supports education. In my first book, Mathophobia, and my second book, Answers Unleashed, I talk about the importance of educating people to think critically so they can solve problems. And these problems are not just the problems that we see in a math book, but it's the problems that we see in everyday real life. For myself, when I had to grow up in poverty and didn't have much to eat, when I turned to mathematics and science, it allowed me to be able to find solutions in all the other areas of my life. And so today I am happy to give keynote lectures to schools across the United States and abroad to help people understand mathematics and science to solve our most pressing problems across the world.
Yeah, such an inspiration, Olympia, to young girls and boys out there as well who hope to one day maybe be an astronaut, the ultimate dream for a child.
Yes, yes. One of my very, very dear friends, Robert Kerbeam, he is a great friend, and I was talking with him on the phone yesterday, and I asked him, what is it like to walk into space? And he was telling me about the three things: to make sure that you're tethered, and make sure that you know where your partner is, and to make sure that you always are keeping out of the danger zones. And that aspect and that type of thinking is what a scientist needs. It needs to have teamwork, need to know what areas to stay out of, and know exactly what your mission is. And so I'm very thankful to help others be able to see that concept and find solutions in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics.
Thank you, Olympia, for being one of those mentors and heroes kids can look to.
Yeah, and if you can still hear me, do you. Keep doing you. We're so proud of you.
I know. Incredible story. Olympia, thank you.